different treatment options available for so many different arm injuries, it can be tricky to distinguish the difference between a cast, an orthosis, and an exos brace. So if you watched our last video, we sort of spoke about a couple of these. We're gonna go more in depth this time. So tell me, Cassandra, what is the main difference between a cast, an orthosis, and an exos brace?
So firstly, a cast, I'll start with that because most people know what a cast is. So a cast essentially is using either fiberglass tape or plaster of Paris material to wrap the joint, and then it sets in a very conforming, firm manner, which someone then can't take off, or you really don't have any movement there.
And it's on for about 6 or 8 weeks.
Yeah, that's right. Sometimes they have some changes in between, so you might have the first one for a couple of weeks and then change it. But yeah, generally for about 6 weeks that people would have a cast on. So yeah, that's probably
the common one that we all
know. And then the thermoplastic splints, I've got an example here. So thermoplastic splints are made of a low temperature thermoplastic. Mm-hmm. So we make these as the as our client or patient is in our rooms at the initial appointment. So it's not something that we have to sort of go away and mold and then come back and fit. So we melt the sheets in the rooms. We've taken some measurements of the patient's wrist, and then we're actually able to lay the thermoplastic material on the limb and shape it around so that it ends up being sort of like a mold, I guess you'd call it. But this is actually what we then make the splint out of. The plastic becomes the splint. And this one's done up with Velcro. And then the exos brace is a different product again. So the exos brace is actually, again, it's custom moldable. So we do heat it up again and use that same conforming skills that we have to really shape it around a patient. But it is made of slightly different material. So whereas the thermoplastic's obviously a plastic material, this is a little bit more squishy, but still very rigid. It's microbial, if I've got that word right. So essentially it's designed to make sure that the skin doesn't become really nasty and bacterial underneath it. It's translucent on x-ray, so it doesn't actually have to come off for an x-ray. They actually x-ray through it. And then the other reason we tend to use these ones is that you can get a key to them. So you can actually lock someone in there. So for normally a smaller child, that can be a very useful thing to know that they can't slip it on and off.
Yeah, perfect.
But they're all waterproof. So we can make waterproof casts because we do casts sometimes. In certain circumstances, we choose that a cast is the option to use. So we can have waterproof cast. These are certainly waterproof, they're just plastic, so it's very waterproof. And these ones as well, they take a little bit more drying, but we just open them all up and then you actually just use a cool hair dryer through it, and then Bob's your uncle, it's dry again.
It's so much better than a cast.
So much better than a cast. Yeah, so absolutely. Better.
So tell me then, what's the difference in cost? Because obviously, you know, if you've gone to the hospital, you've gotten the cast on, they can come and see you, get that cast removed and get one of these, is that right?
Absolutely, yeah. So these ones are generally about, depending on the size of them, but essentially from a child to an adult, you're looking at about $50 to $90, depending on the size, for your average wrist sort of fracture, so a broken radius or something like that, which is a pretty common one. For the thumb, it's generally between about $40 or $60 for a smaller one. Mm-hmm. And then sometimes if they have private health insurance, that's fully rebatable because they're custom made. So they tick that box from a private health rebate point of view.
And that, you know, I guess with private health as well, like you were telling me a story about a lady that came over from the hospital, got referred over, and she's only out of pocket $20.
That's exactly right. So we had a lady the other day, because I was sort of looking up the prices to have a chat to you about them. And there was a lady who came over from the Mater hospital they went to, got sent straight over to us to have the splint versus having a cast put on it. And when she got the rebate from the consultation and her rebate for the splint, she was out of pocket $20.
Yeah, and it's such, like, it's not as impactful on your life having an orthosis or
Absolutely. Well. And you see it every time a patient, like particularly a patient who's had a cast, and then we make one of these and they just feel the freedom straight away. They're just like, oh, thank. And then what they often say is, thank goodness someone sent me here. Yeah. I'm so glad I knew you were here.
Yes.
Yeah.
Because they're really light.
Yeah.
As you said, they're waterproof. So yeah, fantastic. So what are the pros and cons of cast, orthosis, and exos braces?
Yeah, so I mean, I guess the pros and cons, you've heard the pros in terms of the convenience of it, but what's important to understand is there's a different reason we put different fractures or different ages into certain things. So there may be some certain types of fractures that we wouldn't even consider thermoplastic brace or an excess brace, and we do really want them immobilized in a cast. Versus there's other types of fractures that potentially aren't as traumatic or aren't as bad, I guess you could say, and we're like, yep, just put them straight in a thermoplastic splint, no problem. So it's more to do with giving the patient choice based around what they need medically.
Yes, because I guess on a cons point of view, the big cast can, you know, immobilize other parts of the body that don't need to be immobilized.
That's right. So when we use a cast, often when we choose to use a cast, it's because the elbow needs to be kept still. And we can do that with a splint, but sometimes, particularly for children, we just find if the elbow needs to be kept still, they are actually better off in a cast. But from a cons perspective, if they don't need their elbow included, or they don't need their fingers included, or they don't need the majority of their arm included, then why cast? You know, because the cast, you often, because of the shape of the tape and the size of the tape, in general, you often immobilize more than you generally need to. Whereas a thermoplastic, you can get so finite, you can make it so custom that you're basically only immobilizing exactly what needs to be kept still, and then everything else can be kept free, whether that's the fingers, the elbows, the thumb, whatever it is. And that gives people freedom.
Because what can often happen is you eventually get that cast taken off and you've got weakness in other areas and you've got to do a lot of physio, or it takes a really long time to get your...
Exactly.
Before.
And what we're really learning is that if we immobilize an area for too long, or if it doesn't need to be immobilized, then we're actually causing weakness within other structures. So yes, we might be fixing the bone, but we're actually making ligaments quite weak. And if the ligaments are weak, then they're going to have trouble with weight bearing and things later on. So there's actually quite a lot of science that's going into early movement, so reducing the amount of immobilization time and moving a little bit earlier. And they're all things that we factor when we're making a choice on what the best thing is for that particular broken bone.
Yeah, I love it. So there you have it. There's the differences between the Exos brace, the orthosis, and a cast. So if any of this is still a little bit confusing, don't worry. You can leave it all up to the experts at Helping Hands. If you have any pain and injury or concern about your fingers, wrists, hands, elbows, arms, or shoulders, Helping Hands are here to help. So don't hesitate to get in touch with Cassandra and her friendly team today. They're the upper limb experts and they'd love to assist you. And this is so much better, let me tell you, parents, than one of those big clunky casts.